It was the grandest and most glamorous event of the social calendar before the First World War. Then it became more bohemian in the 30s. Art students demolish one another's floats before they even reach the judges. In the 60s, it was banned because too many couples let the romance and the booze go to their heads and sundry other parts.
Well, the Chelsea Arts Ball used to be the most scandalous event in the London calendar. It was famous for its colour, imagination, gaiety and sexual licence. And we feel that's just about what London is lacking in a recession.
So we can look forward to fun and frolics on Sunday night?
You certainly can.
It used to have the most outrageous reputation, though, didn't it?
It certainly did. I mean, one year they tried to bring in a live elephant. The fancy dress got more and more outrageous, to one point they just practically said nude as the theme.
For those who prefer to at least begin the evening with their clothes on, there's a fancy dress competition. Some of the stars are having their costumes specially designed.
They start off with an idea and then I try and persuade them to wear one of these outfits, you know. So the thing is, they look really mega amazing with all these colours, the black and the gold and the red. Ku was going to be a water lily, but I've managed to persuade her to be a pirate. So she's going to look amazing.
So it doesn't really matter what idea people come in with. They go out looking the way you decide
they will.
They go
out processed, yes.
Ku is Ku Stark, of course. The entire cast of the Rocky Horror Show are going as sunflowers. The Chippendales haven't said what they're going as.
I mean, we kick off with Shirley Bassey, with the singing her greatest hits with the Count Basie Orchestra. And she's then going to be joined by that boy over the valleys, Tom Jones, and Elvis Costello. Then we've got what started out as the Dave Gilmour House Band has turned into a set by the Pink Floyd themselves, which is incredibly exciting.
A snip at £25 to £100 a ticket. Sunday's expected to raise not just eyebrows, but an awful lot of money for the AIDS Crisis Trust and the Chelsea Arts Club Foundation. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.